Fish is fish. At the edge of the woods, there was a pond, and the minnow and a tadpole swam among the weeds. They were inseparable friends. One morning, the tadpole discovered that during the night he had grown two little legs. "Look," he said triumphantly. "Look, I am a frog." "Nonsense," said the minnow. "How could you be a frog if only last night you were a little fish just like me?" They argued and argued until finally the tadpole said, "Frogs are frogs and fish is fish, and that is that." In the weeks that followed, the tadpole grew tiny front legs and his tail got smaller and smaller. And then one fine day, a real frog now, he climbed out of the water and onto the grassy bank. The minnow too had grown and had become a full-fledged fish. He often wondered where his pathetic friend had gone. But days and weeks went by and the frog did not return. And one day, with a happy smile, the frog jumped into the pond. "Where have you been?" asked the fish excitedly. "I've been about the world, hopping here and there," said the frog, "and I have seen extraordinary things." "Like what?" asked the fish. "Birds," said the frog mysteriously. "Birds," and he told the fish about the birds. "We had wings and two legs and many, many colors." As the frog talked, his friend saw the birds fly through the sky like large feathered fish. "What else?" asked the fish impatiently. "Cows," said the frog. "Cows. They have four legs, horns, eat grass, and carry pink bags of milk." "And people," said the frog. "Men, women, children," and he talked and talked until it was dark in the pond. But the picture in the fish mind was full of lights and colors and marvelous things, and he couldn't sleep. Ah, if he could only jump about, let his friend see that wonderful world. And so the days went by. The frog had gone and the fish just lay there dreaming about birds in flight, grazing cows, and those strange animals, all dressed up that his friend called people. One day, he finally decided that come what may, he too must see them. And so, with a mighty wag of the tail, he jumped clear out of the water onto the bank. He landed in the dry, warm grass, and there he lay, grasping for air, unable to breathe or to move. "Help!" he groaned feebly. Luckily, the frog, who had been hunting butterflies nearby, saw him and with all his strength pushed him back into the pond. fish floated for an instant. Then he breathed deeply, letting the clean, cold water run through his gills. Now he felt weightless again, and with an ever so slight motion of the tail, he could move to and fro, up and down as before. The sun rays reached down over the leaves and gently shifted patches of luminous color. This world was surely the most beautiful of all worlds. He smiled at his friend the frog, who sat watching him from a little leaf. "You were right," he said. "Fish is fish."